graduates of the class of 2013. My name is Ony Momah, and it's one of the greatest honors of my life to provide this address on behalf of the class of 2013 College of Health Related Professions here at Carnegie Hall. Super great honor. I would like to begin by thanking Dr. Williams for his outstanding leadership, the Board of Trustees, esteemed professors, mentors, and members of the faculty who most are proud alumni of this university. Distinguished guests, friends, and members of the Downstate family, we all thank you for your support. Please give them a round of applause. To the mothers, fathers, and loved ones here today, I'm sure this is not the first graduation that you have attended, but perhaps no other graduation has excited you like this one, as you have likely waited for us to solve that lower back pain, treat your persistent headaches, or stop that nagging cough. And after 2 years of PA school, rest assured that we can still do none of those things. Parents, thank you for your patience and your support. Graduates, give your parents a huge round of applause. I'd like to give a special thanks to the physician assistant faculty, especially Professor Felix Wamagina. Professor Wamagina, I've been in your office, one could say, too many times. And if you know Professor Wamagina, you know one of his favorite sayings is, and I quote, you know, let me say this. And I'm not saying this to brag, and then he brags about something. Professor Medina, you always said it isn't your duty to make friends with the students or be popular with the students for popularity's sake, but to make sure that we graduate and successfully pass our pens, our boards. I respect you, I look up to you, and I will emulate you as a PA on the field, or as a physician assistant professor once you give me that job. You have my resume. Please give the faculty a huge round of applause. When I told my attendant I would be speaking here at graduation, he gave me a look of confusion. He's like, I don't get it. I thought one of the smart students spoke at graduation. I then replied, you know, some of us, including myself, are graduating summa cum laude. Woo! Others are graduating magna cum laude. Woo! I don't know who you are. Well, the rest of us are just graduating thank you laude. Congratulations to this distinguished class of graduates. Please give yourselves a round of applause. A renowned American author once said, crayons. We can learn a lot from crayons. Some are sharp, while others are dull. Some are more popular than others, and some are pretty. Some have weird names, and all are different colors. But the most important part is, they all fit in the same box. My full name is Ony Momah. Kenichi McNatt Moore.
Woo!
And I'm one of those Nigerian crayons with the weird name.
Woo!
My mother and father's names are Nathan and Gloria Momah. Don't ask. Mom, Dad, without you guys, I surely would not be here today. I love you guys so much. Thank you. believe said quote aptly describes SUNY Downstate Medical Center. For SUNY Downstate is an ethnically diverse university located in the heart of one of the nation's largest and most diversified urban communities, mixed with different cultures, customs, and religions. And amongst that diversity, there is a community. A community that is medically underserved, in need for medical practitioners like us. My classmates and I may be of different color, race, and creed, but we all fit in that same box. We all share that same goal. It is why we chose this profession. And that goal is to serve. You know, when I first arrived at SUNY Downstate, and I'm sure you guys can relate, it was tough, challenging, and at times outright torture, Professor Ian. How many of you guys remember Gross Anatomy? Remember those days? Man, I'm still trying to figure out what cranial nerve controls the sense of hearing. Where does it originate? And what fibers is it? GVE, SVE, GVA, JVS, anyone you know? I'm glad I'm not alone with that one. I know the last 2 to 3 years with all the schoolwork, homework, and clinical work has pushed us mentally, physically, and emotionally. But frankly, would we want it any other way? No. In this world of medicine, as health-related practitioners, where else do we get to assist in live operation on a human brain, or play detective to diagnose mysterious ailments? Where else can we get the satisfaction of rehabilitating a young athlete back into playing shape? Where else can we assist in restoring the ADLs to a stroke patient? Where else can we build cutting-edge tools improving the quality of care for patients in this modernized era of EMR systems? Where else would you witness the smile on a mother's face when she hears the first heartbeats of her unborn child? Or you see the elation on a mother holding her newborn infant? Where else are people trusting you with their deepest concerns and secrets? Graduates, I commend you for choosing a profession of service. And never forget how unique, and more importantly, how fun your job really is. And in closing, I want to share one of my favorite Bible verses with you. It's 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 11. It reads, "When I was a child, I spoke as a child. I thought as a child. I reasoned as a child. But when I became a man, I gave up those childish things." During our time here at SUNY Downstate, there was a lot of growing, a lot of life-changing experiences, lessons learned, skills developed, and friendships forged. And as president, I was opportune to meet and almost know everyone in this graduating class. And we are not the same people we were 2 or 3 years ago. And I don't like to brag, but I'm gonna brag. Let me tell you guys something about this class. We are awesome. In our short time here at SUNY Downstate, the church class of 2013 has given back to the community. We held food drives for the homeless, those that are less fortunate. For Hurricane Sandy, we continue to help those affected. We won't stop. For our future generation involved in the Brooklyn Boys and Girls Club, much of our fundraising efforts are directly improving their lives. Honestly, I love this class. Now it's time for us, for you, for you, for you and each and every one of you guys to go out there and be the best Downstate alums that we could be. Thank you.